get any more. I did an x-ray, and I don't have any way to check for liver damage outside of making her pee. I already did that. Occupation: toddler. Sure. Okay. That's my job. Toddler. Way to not address the problem at all. It seemed alright. Let's see. Pediatric floor. Let's see. Emergency. Consultation. Pediatrics. Not urology. The other one. Internist. One sec. No, never mind. Have I killed any people yet? Not yet. Social services. I'm taking that kid away. That baby's mine. Ha ha. I don't think I need to call the police, though. Intensive care, pediatric? It seems a little extreme, but Tylenol kind of eats your liver, so let's not do that. Holding orders? Nah, none of those. Transport? I guess she doesn't need a gurney, she doesn't need a wheelchair. Monitor with MD, the docs probably have something better to do, so RN it is. There's an unknown eating thing in here somewhere. There it is. Acetaminophen overdose. Discharge. Probably not yet. We haven't made the kid barf yet. Prescriptions, aftercare. Nope. Calling it there. Tim stole the child. Yeah, she's got a person in her tummy. You never know. Well, it's because the mother doesn't seem very nice. The Asian mother... I didn't call social services this time because she at least seemed like she cared. This mother's kind of like, oh, you're not going to arrest me, right? My kid's kind of dying, but just don't send me to jail. I think I did do social services. No, I don't need it for discharge. Because I'm not discharging the kid, I'm keeping the kid in the hospital. Did I check for Reye's syndrome? I didn't, but Reye's syndrome is for aspirin, I think. And it only said it found Tylenol metabolites. So acetaminophen, it is. What did the mom do? She was being a jerk. Hey man, don't arrest me because my kid ate all these pills, alright? And the mom is totally shaking that kid. I don't know how many points that is, because my name is way too long. Oh god. That's what you get.
Creep. Loser. Now they're gonna take away my daughter.
You good.
Happy? You're just doing this because we're poor and you think we can't fight back.
Yep.
You better watch your back, dog. This isn't the last you'll hear from me.
I hate poor people.
You've made it to second year. Excellent.
Yeah.
Not all of the first years were as successful as you were, but that was to be expected. You should be very proud of yourself. Keep up the good work.
I hope she shows up in the sequel.
The patient will live, but just barely by these numbers. The Drake case.
Who's this?
Yes, I heard the mother and daughter were quite the comedy team.
Oh, the pregnant kid.
Let's go over it. I'm glad to see you checked rhythm. In a case like this, it's crucial.
I think that was successful.
I found this patient's BP particularly telling. You did too. Good work. If you had run a complete blood count, the results would have indicated elevated white blood count.
They would have done what?
Confirming an infection. Sharp
I'm
eyes,
sorry, what?
Doctor. This patient's weak state demanded the introduction of intravenous fluids.
For those words?
Good. You injected antibiotics to help the patient's immune system battle the infection. Communication is key,
Oops.
Doctor. You can't expect the hospital staff to read your mind. Record the patient's hospital orders for admittance and recommended treatment.
Dude, I have no idea. How am I supposed to know?
Appendicitis. A good call, especially when the mother was doing her best to throw you off track. You saved this patient's life, Doctor. Well done.
I gloved her. I forgot to hit one of the buttons on the machine.
I know we don't want to aggravate a patient's condition, but
don't poke the patient
in the eye. Confirming and locating pain are vital to a proper diagnosis. I know we don't want to aggravate a patient's condition.
You said that.
But confirming and locating pain are vital to a proper diagnosis.
Yes.
A very nasty break. Often with head and neck trauma, there may be other subtle internal injuries. You were correct in ordering this
CT. God, this game.
A very nasty break. X-rays are costly, Doctor, and in
a
this case, not required. Before you treat the wound, it's important to cleanse the area. Well done.
Oh, I mean, yes.
Head and neck trauma, you don't take chances. X-rays are a must.
But you said X-rays were expensive.
Sharp eyes, Doctor. This patient's weak stage 8 demanded the introduction of intravenous fluids. Good. You injected antibiotics to help the patient's immune system battle the infection.
Game's breaking down.
Way to identify the break and use the splint to immobilize it. Looks like your sewing skills came in handy in this case, didn't they, Doctor? It's nice to see you didn't forget the basics. You needed to bandage the wound, and you did. You correctly applied topical medication.
Into his
eye. You forgot a few items, but on the whole, your discharge orders were good. You signed the patient into the hospital, but failed to list a comprehensive plan for hospital care.
Sorry.
Be more careful next time. Often our intuition can mislead us. You made the wrong diagnosis for this patient.
No, I didn't.
And it cost a life.
No, I didn't. Wait, it cost a life? Did you just say this cost a life? I did the exact freaking thing you... God! How did he die? How? Please, explain that. He's not dead. He got up and said, I'm fine. Thanks, Doc. But no. No, he's... Oh, could have cost a life. I guess that's okay. What was I supposed to write? Find the one that said diagnosis? Right humerus fracture. Rib fractures. Right humerus fracture. Oh, well, you did a damn good job killing that patient back there.
You did what you had to do to save the patient, but just barely.
I didn't sponge his eye. Oh, I did sponge his eye. I forgot to magnify his chest or glove his head. I'll know for next time.
Unknown ingestion. It's sad how many cases like this we receive. It truly is.
Man, the kid's hungry.
Signs of wheezing,
what
labored breathing, or rapid breaths.
What happened to this baby?
Helped the patient by administering oxygen via mask.
The baby's exploding.
Right. Sharp eyes, Doctor. This patient's weak state demanded the introduction of intravenous fluids. Correct. The nasogastric tube was required
I'm
for this
so
patient.
Lost.
You forgot a vital treatment. The NG tube should have been inserted for this patient.
I did. It went
you
in the nose.
You completed a majority of the required hospital orders for this patient.
I totally put the NG tube in.
You conducted your examination, assisted the patient, and came to the right conclusion.
I'm so lost.
You saved this patient's life, Doctor. Well done.
Missing procedures. It didn't even say I didn't do the NG tube. Because the NG tube is right there. You're just making up stuff. There's no one here. Well,
He's back.
Oh, great.
Your good buddy, Monty. Says he has a headache, double vision, and asks if I would mind finding a portable TV for him to watch while he's in the exam room.
I'm gonna send him...
Oh, and he requested...
...to the cops.
I think my skull is dying. Can it do that?
I think my skull is dying. Mine too, Monty. Mine too.
The good old EKG. My heart's a flutter.
I got 60 points just for that. There's like obviously nothing to do.
Uh-oh. That look. It's the big C, isn't it?
Oops. Never gonna know what the big C is. Well, I gloved his head. Do you have brain damage? Oops, kind of missed your eye, but...
You're so gentle. I could fall asleep.
Thanks.
If I do, can I stay the night? It's like a constant throbbing behind my eyeballs.
Does that mean...
And the back of my head, too.
Nope, that's a normal brain.
Wow. You've really taken your medicine up a notch, huh?
Oh, I'll make you take some medicine, Monty. There.
You've improved since my last visit.
I'm gonna overdose you on Tylenol now.
Can I get a Jell-O cup? No lime this time, okay?
Wanna know what else is red? Like your Jell-O? Your blood!
Get a good look. It's something serious, I know it.
Oh man, he totally broke his thumb there. Can I go now? I have 151 points. I'm done. Go away, Monty. Hospital orders. Get lost. Emergency console. Nope. I don't think he gets any emergency anything. Transport. Nope. Diagnosis. I don't know. Headache. Is headache an option? Is he Latino? I guess. Do you have a gunshot wound I didn't notice? Not toothache. Headache. Tension headache. Like, the most mild headaches on the list. It's probably not a skull fracture. Has bonitis. What if I just send him to surgery? What then? What if I just say, hey, I'm sorry, you're dying. Have fun. Here, here's an analgesic. Police. Nah. As much as I want to do police, I don't think that's the right thing. He's dying of abusive fake-ism. Yeah, he might have the big C. Why am I not doing psych? Because I think you're just supposed to play with him. Not honestly think he's nuts. He's just lonely. I actually did defib him. I just sort of killed him the first time. Because surgery's going to be correct. Okay, fine. I was afraid if I put psych and surgery for two joke answers, then he would really get a bunch of points taken off. Figured if I hedge my bets by picking just one or the other, it might be okay. I forgot to save his skull. I defibbed him the first time. He probably comes back. I can't imagine him being dead the whole time. Oh, I should have done home healthcare so we'd have someone to talk to. Wait, is he stealing from the...
You scared me.
I'm going to kill you.
Have I mentioned what a great job you've just done?
I should have called the cops.
You're going to be chief of staff before you know it. Okay. See ya. I gotta run.
Have fun in surgery, jerk.
My little darlings. Huh? Pick up the phone.
Can't
it's
hear
Mama.
You. Oh.
Pick it up, darlings. What are you doing over there?
I live alone.
Do I hear fighting? Stop that. Now you stop that. When I get home.
I saw everything. Okay, call you later, Dad.
One minute he was playing with his friends, and the next he's on the ground. Knees swollen within an hour.
Oh, wait, is it this kid?
I can't be expected to keep my eyes on him every minute. Boys will be boys, you know. What concerns us Chris, would you like to play?